Hi, I'm John Gettys, Mayor of the City of Rock Hill. It's my pleasure to welcome you again for a great conversation. It's Christmasville season here in Rock Hill, which means we get to do a lot of fun things and celebrate the season. And well, quite frankly, today is just a day to have a very special guest. It's somebody that we all know, and I get to say, I know him, Santa Claus.
Hello, Mayor. Thank you for having me in beautiful Rock Hill.
Well, we're glad to have you as always. Christmasville is upon us again.
And indeed it is.
It wouldn't be right if we didn't have you on to interview you. So I've got a few questions for you today.
Well, I hope I got a few answers for you.
I'm sure you will. So first, what's your favorite part about Christmasville?
Oh, gosh, it has to be the people. It has to be. I mean, so many places that you go and it's just everybody's in a rush, in a hurry. Christmasville, you kind of get to settle down. I get to meet the kids. I get to go to all the wonderful things. And to see the involvement from everybody is so, it's a rare thing. And Rock Hill should be very proud of it.
Well, we are. And it's because we love you so
well,
much.
I appreciate
and love each
that.
Other so much. So first question really I have for you is, if you could have only one for the rest of your life, would it be milk, cookies, or something else?
Well, Mrs. Claus would love for me to say milk,
right,
but I'm going to say the official answer is cookies.
Cookies, yes. Don't blame you there. Chocolate chip, of course.
Oh, absolutely. Loaded down. The more, the better.
Where do you like to go on vacation?
Vacation, I like to get away from the snow.
Right.
So I like to send somewhere tropical.
Yeah.
And it's kind of hard to be incognito with all this white beard. So I get a big straw hat, big sunglasses, and just lay underneath a palm tree somewhere.
That sounds
what I
good.
Like
yes, sir.
Absolutely.
So Councilmember Jim Reno, is he on your naughty list or nice list?
Okay, here we go. We're going to list them all. Believe it or not, Jim Reno, he's on the nice list.
Yeah, I could see that.
Yep.
Yeah, I could
absolutely
see that. Derek Lindsay?
Derek has been on it since day one.
Oh.
I'll give Derek credit. He's on the nice list.
I'm not sure his wife would agree with that, but, you know. How about Kathy Pender?
It kind of pains me to say this, and Kathy's on the naughty list.
I can see that.
She's on the naughty list.
I can see that, Sam.
There's still time to change it around,
right,
but as of today,
yes, sir,
this moment, bless her heart, she's on the naughty list.
Well, we'll make sure she sees this video real quick.
That's right. Sam. Turn it around, Kathy. I'm pulling for you.
Kevin Sutton.
Kevin Sutton, you know, he's actually on the nice list.
Shut the front door.
He's on the nice list. Kevin, make check payable to Santa Claus.
John Black.
John Black, easy. Nice list. All day long.
All right. Well, we're doing good.
We
last
are doing
one
good.
I think we have is Perry Sutton.
I was hoping we wouldn't have to do this.
Oh.
Perry, unfortunately, is on the naughty list.
Oh, no.
Can
not
you believe
Perry
it?
Sutton.
Can you believe it?
I cannot.
Oh, but here
he's
again.
He's a deacon in the church,
in
and he's
the
on the
church.
Naughty. Yes, sir.
But he still has time to turn things around.
Well, that's good.
So, Perry, I'm pulling for you. Come on, you can do it.
What's your favorite color, Santa?
Red.
Red.
Red all day long. If
yeah.
I see red, I like green. I
right.
like gold and silver, but red's got to be the top.
Right.
Easy one for me.
Well, I sort of figure that one out, I guess. So Christmasville starts tomorrow night. Well, Thursday night.
Thursday night is the official kickoff. We'll be at Fountain Park,
yes,
which I'm hoping folks that see this would come for the first time and experience it.
Mm-hmm.
Fountain Park is like the mini Bellagio.
Yes,
I
sir.
Mean, Rock Hill, you just don't understand how wonderful things are here. We'll be on the stage, we'll be out there, and that's the kickoff. And you'll see some of the community involvement beginning Thursday night and followed by photos with yours truly
oh, yes,
right sir. Next door at the church. And we call that Cookies with Santa.
Oh, yeah.
So come out, come one, come all, as
really?
I would say.
It's always fun that opening night to see the Rock Hill Rockettes and
it
so
truly
many
is.
Others.
And it truly is, and there's just something magical about it. And even the stage, the way it's set up, the ice skating rinks behind
yes,
us,
sir.
And at the very end we have snow. Believe it or not, we have snow, and it's wonderful. It's beautiful, and it kicks off the festival in such a nice way, where it puts everybody. And I understand tomorrow night's going to be really cool.
Oh, good.
Which like in the 30s, when I say cool, like Santa weather, you know, Santa weather. So
yes, sir.
That even helps you get into the Christmas spirit, because Florida, I feel sorry for those folks.
Yeah.
86 degrees. Santa's melting, snowman melts.
Yes,
so we've got the weather set up good for tomorrow.
Well, so that is good to hear. And yes. It's been doing this 17 years, I believe.
17 years is how long Christmasville's been going on. And they say, you know, every year is bigger and better. It really is. Mm-hmm. And I think a lot of it is because the people come, how can I get involved?
Right.
And as you know more than anyone, Rock Hill's growth has been phenomenal. And so a lot of the new businesses and the call, how can we be a part of this? Because when you see something fun, you don't run away from it, you run towards it. And that's what folks are doing. They realize, man, this is something special. And it truly is.
It really is. The organizing committee, all the volunteers that do this, there's a reason it gets an award about every year.
The other thing I think the public may not understand is just how much work goes into it. I know that's an old cliche. You hear it all the time, but it truly is. I mean, it takes a village to put on something this size. And they cross the T's and dot the I's and just do, it's truly magical.
Well, I can imagine at this time of year, Santa, your time is really short. You have a lot to do, and I think it says a lot for every year to come back to Rock Hill to sort of kick off this season. Tells you just how much you appreciate the work people do here. And it's really a testament to that, I think.
With my Santa work, I'm fortunate to travel quite a bit. Mm-hmm. But Rock Hill, it strikes a chord with me that few places can. And it's because of that feeling of home, that sense of community, just the participation that folks do. And I'm fortunate enough, I get to see behind the scenes. And the behind the scenes is just as remarkable to me as what goes on out front. So as long as I'm able, and the good Lord willing, Santa will always be here in Rock Hill.
Well, thank you. We love to hear that.
It's my pleasure.
So we know about the kickoff is on Thursday night, December 1st.
Yes.
But the next night is one of my favorites. It's when you see pretty much everybody in Rock Hill come out, the parade.
The parade. And it is a parade. The thing I think I like the most about Rock Hill Christmas Parade is the fact that it's in the evening and that it's lit up.
Mm-hmm.
And as you know, Santa's the very last thing in the parade.
Sir.
And so I get a bird's eye view. I'm up high. I can see all the things. We're 4 and 5 deep all along Oakland Avenue. But the most remarkable thing is when we make that final turn onto Main Street and it's lit up. And I usually am waving and singing, but I stop for a moment just to take a breath because that view of old downtown and all the Christmas lights and the people, you can't walk. I mean, it's wall to wall. It is, if there's magic, that's magic.
Santa, I couldn't agree with you more. I'm usually at the front of the parade. They like to get me out of the way.
I think.
But it's the same thing. You come around that corner and you look at the Anderson Hotel and these others that were never here in the history of Rock Hill.
True.
And now you have people out on their stoops.
On the balconies. Don't
clapping,
you love that?
Clapping, exciting, and kids right up. It is that stretch, that home stretch. There's the energy there. It's just
and, you
fabulous.
Know, we've already been all the way down. So our hands are getting heavy by then. But there's something. It just rejuvenates you. And from there all the way to Fountain Park, it's just like, make it last longer. It's just, it's unbelievable. And you know, the parade is such that I know there have probably been years where I think you finish before I ever hit the road.
Yes, sir.
Because I'm way back at Tillman.
Yes, sir.
And that's just a wonderful thing.
Yeah.
And there, when I come through, nobody has left. Everybody is staying.
Yes, sir.
And so, the parade's way up there on my list.
Yes, sir. Me too. And then, of course, activities Saturday and Sunday all
Saturday,
over the
all
place.
Saturday all day long and mainly in the downtown area. But, you know, we have, I mean, one other thing that Rock Hill does, and I wanted to say something about, we have the Ferris wheel. We have all of these carnival rides and stuff. And they don't charge the kids one single dime. There's no festival you can go to where everything, where the rides and all are free. But Christmasville does that. And that in and of itself is a Christmas moment, you know.
Sir.
So thankful for the corporate sponsors. Mm-hmm. And it takes a lot. I mean, but to come in and know that kid doesn't have to worry, the parents don't have to worry about buying a $20 wristband so little Johnny can ride the merry-go-round, guess what? It's free.
Yes, sir.
And that's a wonderful thing.
It is. It's sometimes I even think I catch the Grinch smiling. He's so happy down there.
Well, it's a rare thing when that rascal smiles, I'll tell you. But you'll see him around.
Yes,
he'll be out all day Saturday. And And the other thing is I try to be as mobile as possible.
Yes, sir.
So if you happen to miss me here, just I'll be back.
Yes, sir.
And I'll be around. We go and we try to get that whole downtown area covered and just to see as many folks as we can. We learned several years ago that, and this is how I love that Christmasville adapts, we have Santa's Workshop, and I need all the kids to come out. This is where I get most of my reindeer. They make reindeer food for
me.
And that's very important.
Yes.
Because when I go back, man, the guys just go crazy. He's been to Rock Hill. He's going to bring us reindeer food. But we used to sit Santa in a chair for 8, 9, 10, 12 hours, and the lines tended to get long.
Sure.
So we didn't want parents to have to stand in line for 2 hours, 3 hours, just to get to see Santa. So instead of them coming to Santa, Santa goes to them.
Mm.
It's hard to find anybody who doesn't have a camera on them nowadays.
That's true.
So we walk up and down the street. We do jingle bell parades. We get on the Ferris wheel with the kids. So instead of being locked up in a corner, you know, I'm going to come see you. So if you miss me, I'll be there. I'll see you at some point during the festival, and that's a wonderful thing.
Oh, it really is.
So, love being mobile.
Well, so you mentioned your reindeer. Who's your favorite?
It's got to be Dasher.
Dasher.
It's got to be Dasher.
What's Dasher got
Dasher's
on everybody else?
Dasher's athletic.
Yeah.
He and I can talk sports, and the rest of them just don't. And Dasher does a lot of the training for the guys. In fact, right now he's got them on a strict diet. Some of them couldn't get much off the ground the other day. We were doing test runs, and I was like, whew. Y'all wait till Dasher gets here. So when I left, all I saw him was running around the field. So
they're getting
but
ready.
But I'm sure by Christmas Eve he'll have them all ready to go. But I think maybe I've been feeding them too many snacks or something.
Sir.
I don't know.
Your favorite Christmas song?
I think my very favorite Christmas song is "O Holy Night."
Mm.
Of course, I try to always remember the reason for the season.
Because
without that, none of us would be here. But I also like "It's a Most Wonderful Time of the Year," because for me, it truly is the most wonderful time of the year. So I always kind of tag into that as much as I can.
Yes, sir.
So,
well, I need you to settle something for us.
Okay,
you're
here we go.
You're going to be the guy that's going to decide.
I'm the official expert on whatever subject you want to speak on.
All right, so Die Hard, is it a Christmas movie or not?
I've heard folks go both ways. Here's what you need to know about Santa. I am a traditionalist. To me, Christmas movies are the ones like It's a Wonderful Life, even Scrooge, maybe Elf.
Mm-hmm.
When I think of Die Hard, I understand why people want to consider it a Christmas movie. But the official verdict from Santa is not a Christmas movie.
Okay. You heard it here first. What is your favorite Christmas movie, Santa?
It's a Wonderful Life.
Yeah.
It's a Wonderful Life. Capra. Mm-hmm. I mean, how can you just, that nostalgia and that feeling that I'm sure we all have those kind of feelings, but just to know that when you live the kind of life that's a good life, people are there. People want to help people. And sometimes they don't know how to help people, but they want to help people. And sometimes I think we take for granted that some of the good things that we do may be paid back in ways that we have no idea. And so that's why I love the magical part of this, you know.
Yeah, you're saying I agree. You know, there's something I think in each of us, a yearning to do things bigger than ourselves.
Absolutely.
To believe in things bigger than ourselves that pulls us, drags us sometimes to think about, you know, how do you escape the modern day and do something that's just above and beyond what
it's so true. And the one thing, and for various reasons, you know, we've all struggled the last few years. We've had you know, the pandemic, we've had and with social media we seem to distance ourselves. An event like this brings people together.
Yes, sir.
And I love that. There's nothing more pure and valuable than human contact. You know, when I see a child's eyes light up, I know what that means.
Yes, sir.
I don't have to say anything. They don't. It's that moment. You can't get that behind with distance. So I like that this brings people together, because at the end, I think we all pretty much want the same thing.
I agree with
and,
you.
And so that's why I think it's important to keep stuff like this going and growing. And for those of you who hadn't experienced and are sitting at home, come on out this weekend and you'll find out the old guy knows what he's talking about. It's just incredible.
You know, Santa, I'm just sitting here thinking about how wrong I've been for 54 years. love you always have, but to realize just how wise you are. And
well,
I appreciate you sharing that.
I appreciate that.
You know, that's, there is a reason for the season, as
absolutely
you say.
Absolutely there is.
You're the best ambassador for that.
I appreciate it so very much.
So what do you do for fun at the North Pole?
I like to play pranks on my elves.
Oh, really?
I really do.
What's some good pranks you put on an elf?
Well, a lot of times I will hide their tools, and sometimes I'll take their glue and I'll substitute it, or I'll water it down, and then I'll have them bring the gift to me or the toy, and I'll say, "This looks wonderful," and then it'll fall apart. And I'll say, "What kind of work are you guys doing back there?" Literally, they know Santa had kind of got them.
Oh, so. Yes, sir.
But they're getting wise to me now. You know, we've been doing it for quite a while.
Wow.
And they're kind of picking up. So I got to come up with some new prank. If you know any pranks for my elves, let me know. I'd love to get them.
Well, I'm sure you'll get a lot of offers at Christmasville this week.
Absolutely.
So I got to ask about Mrs. Call. Is she doing okay?
This is her busy time as well. This is her busy time. I mentioned about the reindeer trying to get in shape. Well, she keeps up with those elves.
Okay.
And she makes sure that everybody's working and everybody's doing what they can. And she looks after me.
Yes, sir.
And which I understand is pretty much a full-time job. I can't imagine why. So she kind of pushes the cookies away every now and then.
Sir.
And she has to let out my suit every now and then. But other than that, it's her busy time. And we couldn't do it without her. You know,
right.
A lot of us guys, Santa, sometimes even the mayor, we get credit for things that really it's not us. It's the people behind us. I wouldn't be nothing without the people that helped me be what I am.
Yes, sir.
And I always want to recognize that. So Mrs. Claus certainly is one of those folks.
So what does she do when you're out on Christmas Eve and Christmas night doing your job? What's she doing?
She's cleaning. Because when I pull out, it's like a madhouse. We have packages. We have stuff everywhere. She's cleaning, and she's, you know, I think they finally take a deep breath on the 25th, the 26th.
Well, so good for them.
So
well deserved.
Well deserved.
Yes, sir.
Well deserved. And I miss all that fun of cleaning up.
Yeah.
I'm just out there taking all the credit.
Well, Santa, we're going to bring it to a close. I know you got a lot to do. Now, my wife has been on the good list or the nice list for so long, but I can't afford it anymore. So if you could just put her on the naughty list for just this one year, I sure would appreciate it.
I love it. No, you know what? If she's been on the nice list that long, she deserves to stay on it. You just got to tighten up.
I think you're right. Well, welcome to Rock Hill. I know
Thank you.
The kids in town and their parents are so excited. We're at Christmasville. We've got Santa here again. Just a magical, wonderful weekend to come. We thank you. We thank all the volunteers that do so much. The director, the board of directors, the sponsors, as you say, and all the elves in Rock Hill that make sure that Grinch doesn't spoil it.
And the only thing better than Christmasville this year
will
be Christmasville next year.
Amen. Well, thank you, Santa.
Thank you.
Thank you all for watching our show and welcoming Santa back to Christmasville. We look forward to a great one again. Thank you for what you do for the people of Rock Hill.